Hello, fans, and welcome to tonight's game between the Indiana Hoosiers and the Indiana State Scamores. There's a look, Dick, at the starting lineups.
Keep your eyes on these two small forwards, Brad. They're both very talented, and you can expect to see them go at each other all game long.
Tonight, we really have an interesting matchup at the center position. Number 42 might be one of the best floor leaders in the country right now.
The player he'll be guarding tonight is also a great floor general, Brad. This should be a classic matchup.
I couldn't agree more with you, partner. Let's get down to the court and join the action. Points of emphasis, Dick. What do you got for us?
First off, a balanced attack is ideal. If all players are threats to score, the defense will have a tough time focusing on one guy. Secondly, track player fatigue levels throughout the game if endurance appears to be an issue. Sub in some players. Finally, box out and limit the opponent to one shot per possession.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Goes up for two. Perfectly executed. Both teams are looking to get something going here. On the outside. Seconds on the clock with a little baby hook.
Good rebound. Great position on a rebound. Good block out.
Men have got to get out and fill the lanes, Brad.
And up. Perfectly executed. Looks like the defender's a little bit tired out there.
This is no time to be tired. Get a sub if you need a break.
Spacing.
Ten on the shot clock.
Nice ops. Look at that. That's unbelievable, baby.
Two. Can't get the shot to go. Gave it up. Now looking to create with a ball screen.
Hey, the pick and roll is one play that so many teams use these days. A great way to buy a step for the dribbler.
Oh, and you can see the frustration as he picks up the foul.
Oh, that's a bad, bad foul right there, Brad.
Gilbert handles the pass. Tries for two. The lay-in.
Their defense is absolutely horrible.
They are not putting up much of a fight. Callaway handles the feed. They work it around the perimeter. They get an open look for three. 10 seconds on the shot clock.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Turnaround jumper.
Nothing but nylon. Nice, smooth turnaround jumper. The only negative, he's falling away. If he misses, he's got no rebounding ability.
They work the perimeter. And our trifecta for the Knights. Aaron Andrews on the sideline. And with Dick Vitale, I'm Brad Nessler. Nice to have you along with us. The Sycamores prefer a more balanced attack. They play up-tempo at times and then really settling in the half court at other times.
I think when you have balance inside, outside, scoring, tempo control, where you control the pace of the game, and that's what they try to do with their balance. They'll go fast, they'll go slow. They try to dictate tempo.
On the dribble, gives it up. Now looking for the pick.
Hey, it's important that the dribbler really turns that corner hard when he's using that ball screen.
Perfectly executed.
He's got to pass it or make a play, Brad.
Looking for a good shot. With a jumper. Jumper won't go. The point guard with the ball. And the ball goes out of play. Everybody into the act right now, and you can tell by the cheerleaders on the sideline how things are going.
Isn't that what makes college so special? The enthusiasm of the cheerleaders, the mascot, everybody involved.
They'll work it around the arc. Puts up the J. The Sycamores have got to continue to get him the ball.
Brady's on fire.
Gave it up. Taken away.
Gotta take some pride on the defensive end.
Reed receives the pass for the bucket. He knocks down another bucket.
This kid's got skills, Brad.
Smart receives the pass. Goes up for two. Perfectly executed. Number 40 takes the pass.
What a great steal. Defensive player was really right on top of that basketball. Look at this, going coast to coast. Nobody stops the ball. I mean, he just has an open lane, man. You can put a Mack truck through there.
Power forward handles the feed. On the outside. Ten on the shot clock. Turnaround jumper.
Nothing but nylon. Nice, smooth turnaround jumper. The only negative, he's falling away. If he misses, he's got no rebounding ability.
On the dribble, gives it up. Tries to turn, the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
There's a look at the current tempo for the game.
A snail's pace, Brad. That's the tempo of this game. But if that's your philosophy, so be it.
Up and in. The crowd begins to chant.
Who says there's no such thing as a home court advantage?
Picked off. And there's sort of a snapshot of our game tempo.
We've seen a combination of both short and long possessions here, Brad. Nothing wrong with that if that's your team's ideal style of play.
For two. The Hoosiers have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
They need to keep feeding the ball. It's simple.
The lane. Now they work it around the perimeter. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
10 on the shot clock. Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, guys, the difference in scoring jumps out at me. It's a matter of one guy focusing and taking advantage of his shot opportunities, and he's making the most of it.
All right, thanks, Aaron. Aaron Andrews, our sideline correspondent. All of you know that with an additional insight there. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in, then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Tries for two. Up and in. Fires from long range. Makes it.
The replay's not even enough for this one. A little frustration right there. He almost found himself in some trouble there, Brad.
Moving it around the perimeter. Three-point territory, and he misses the shot. No good. Reed receives the ball. Working it around the perimeter. The ball goes out of play. Sloan makes his first substitution.
I'll tell you what I like about him, Brad. He brings all kinds of energy to the floor.
Ten seconds to put it up. They work it around the perimeter. Launches the three. He nails the bucket. Smith receives the pass.
Gotta think right now. Gotta focus defensively.
For the bucket. The layup.
Dump it inside.
Ten seconds to shoot. Gave it up. With tons of room. He drills it from downtown.
That's absolutely sensational, even the second time.
Gives it up. Up and in. Gilbert handles the pass. Open shot. He's got the stroke. Going to move it around the perimeter. Defense! Good defensive stick. Gets a hand in the way.
It's a block party out there.
Number 30 checks in for the first time.
I'll tell you, this is what they need coming off the bench, Brad.
And a momentary look from three-point land. Goes up for two. The lane. The center takes the pass. Gave it up. For two. Up and in. He goes up with it. He misses the jumper.
Let's see if they go two for one here, Brad.
Tries for two. The lay-in. On the dribble, gives it up. Seconds on the clock. The power forward gets the pass. And he goes with a spin.
I tell you, feel the defensive player on your hip going one way, the spin back the other way.
Shot clock is dead. Off the mark. At halftime, the Hoosiers trail by one. We've had a very tight contest tonight, Dick. What's your highlight of the half?
There were some good highlights in that first half, but you got to look at this one. Watch how they got the ball inside for easy scores, which forced the defense to collapse, opening up the perimeter game.
And now let's get ready for the start of the second half. Indiana State displayed a spectacular shooting performance, Dick, in that first half.
Indeed, Brad. I predict the defense will come out and really be a lot sharper in the second half. They better be ready to play.
Garrett checks back in.
Hey, yes, sometimes that quick breather can be the difference, Brad.
Dick, it's all about teamwork, and as we start the second half and take a look at our player matchup update, it's pretty even.
I'd say really great balance out there because you look at the stars right now, they're getting the ball in the right place on the court where they can be effective.
Fed the low block. Turnaround jumper. And a big rebound.
Fill the lanes. That's the only way they'll be able to get some fast break opportunities.
Receives the ball for the bucket. He might be on his way to a career game, partner.
Well, he will, Brad, if they don't get somebody on him in a hurry.
Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Seconds to put up a shot. The Hoosiers have found a player who cannot seem to miss, Dick.
Brad, he's on fire.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
With a good look, he hits the tough shot.
I tell you, he's knocking him down with ease, Brad.
Little two-man action. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
The defender is still applying great ball pressure, Brad.
Up and in.
up and inside.
Goes up for two. Galan.
Defense breaks down again. Nobody rotates over from the help side.
The power forward receives the ball. Up and in. Check out this highlight. And a candidate for our Pontiac game-changing performance. Looking for a good shot. Turnaround jumper. They take it off the defensive glass.
Once you get that board, you've got to be looking up court. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important than how talented guards that they have.
Yeah, that helps. I think they're trying to make it. The layup's good and one, Nick.
Hey, that's good concentration. Taking the ball hard to the hoop, knowing that someone's going to hack you.
At the free throw line. Opportunity. He missed it. On the outside. Ten on the shot clock. Smart receives the ball for two. He rips the nets for another score.
He's absolutely unconscious.
The Scamores have a three-point shooter spotting up. The power forward gets the pass. Ten on the shot clock. He pulls up with a jumper. And nice-looking jumper in the lane. The Hoosiers like to play that half-court style of play. Wouldn't you agree with that?
Bad half-court teams will try to out-execute their opponent. They're extremely patient and try to always utilize the clock.
Look at that spacing.
He shoots from long range. He misses it. Working around the perimeter. Here's a nice face up down on the low block.
Oh, he did a great job face up and then just attacked them and took it to the basket.
Tries for two. The lane.
To get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
For the bucket, perfectly executed. They work the perimeter.
Great pass out of the trap, Rod.
Gilbert receives the ball. Looking for a good shot. Now the turnaround jumper. He takes the rebound. The The small forward takes the pass. Gave it up. Here comes the ball screen. They'll work it around the arc. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper. He gets the board. On the outside. Goes up for two. Up and in. Now they work it around the perimeter. He makes the block, and the ball goes out of bounds. 10 on the shot clock. Here's the inbound play on the baseline. 10 seconds remaining on the shot clock. Tries for two. They still don't score. Number 22 takes the feed. With the fake for the bucket. That is a dagger in the heart, that shot, Dick.
Hey, they lost focus here. They need a timeout to regroup, Rod.
Jumper nails the deuce. On the dribble, gives it up.
Good anticipation defensively.
The lay-in. The Scamores are in a great position with the time and score on their side, and they're going to have to play more in the half court now, Dick.
I think they'll look to settle down. They should be running longer offensive sets, which allow for the ball to move and the clock to wind down. I'll be surprised if there are any early shots.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in, and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
Goes up for two. Up and in. For two, perfectly executed. He's going to see this guy in his sleep tonight, Dick.
He's already living a nightmare, Brad.
Garrett receives the ball. Moving it around the perimeter. Picked out of the air. Working it around the perimeter. Is the net. Cross court. He tries the jumper. Missed it. The small forward takes the feed. Passes it out of the trap. They work it around the perimeter. That spin move not successful, Dick.
I did a great job on the defense, not allowing them to make that turn.
Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, as you know, points in the paint is a stat that coaches will readily look at, comparing their team's dominance in this category with opposition. Establishing that inside presence is an important facet of consistent success.
I think she's right about that, Richie.
I'll tell you, Ern's exactly right. Post play is essential if you're going to be effective.
Tries for two. The Hoosiers have got to continue to get him the ball.
They need to keep feeding him the ball. It's simple.
For the bucket. The lay. Garrett's lowly performance has just gotten in his head.
He's got to snap out of it. His team needs him.
Number 40 receives the ball. He squares up down on the low block.
I tell you, teach your player to face up and get in triple threat position. You can drive, shoot, or you can pass.
Collects the rebound. Thomas receives the pass. That's an ill-advised shot.
Hey, a few more of those, he may wind up on a bench.
On the elbow, they feed down to the low block. Goes up for two. Perfectly executed.
Dumping inside.
Dick, it looks like some of these guys are really getting tired. The small forward receives the ball. Trying to feed inside for two. Perfectly executed. Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper.
There's the offensive rebound on the inside.
Up and in. Pushes it up. The lay-in. The students are all fired up and ready to do whatever's necessary to help their team win.
They look like they're having a blast.
They'll throw it in from the side. The offense begins off the sideline inbounds. The offense sets up from the sideline.
Trying to execute on the inbounds.
Gave it up. They'll throw this one in from the side. He goes to the line for the first time. He makes the front end of the one and one. Gets a second. Escapes the trouble and makes a pass out. He shoots from left of the circle. He misses the jumper. And there's what the game tempo is looking like tonight.
That's exactly what I was thinking, Brad. The pace of this game has been remarkable.
He goes to the line for the first time. Makes the front end of the one and one. second shot. They're seeing them all fall from the line tonight.
That's a crucial plus down the stretch, Brad.
Freeman may have escaped one there. Thomas may have escaped one there. They get an open three. He nails the shot. Passes it out of the trap. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Like to play a half-court style, Dick. What types of players do they usually attract to their program?
They'll never force a shot and will rarely get into a running game, Brad. They realize that they can't play that style and be successful.
Any final thoughts regarding the points of emphasis, Dick?
Brad, a good game plan is important. The points of emphasis are a great guide in helping teams focus on the key components, components which will help a team get that done.
You've got to know your style and play within it. Such an important part of the game. Let's check out today's top play, the Pontiac game-changing performance. Dick, you know, it's always great to look back and see how the marquee matchup is played out.
I'll tell you one thing, Brad, that's great to watch individually, but remember, this is a team game, so it's really how the team responds as a unit.
Indiana State simply blew this team away tonight.
They'll be happy to walk away with a victory from such an evenly matched opponent.
That's going to do it for us, folks. Thanks for being along. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler.